What one or two things would you suggest men do to plan a date? I would say pick the restaurant because women don't like you to show up. Where do you want to go? Where do you want to go? You know, start all down that road. So go ahead and have a restaurant in mind. Do a little research. Try to pick a nice place that you think she would enjoy. Think about the activities that she likes to do and try to cater to that. Pick something obviously that both of you want to do, but try to figure out what she likes to do and then go for that. So you can't go wrong that way.
Jim was a great date planner. Still is. But the dates, the courtship, as you might say,
right,
was perfect. And the way you planned our dates was, it was fantastic. Gentlemen, I would say clean your car. Jim always showed up with a clean vehicle, always, and I appreciated that, and I noticed it because all the guys I was dating weren't always showing up with a clean car. It shows that you care and you put effort into what you're doing, and ladies, if you're dating guys that aren't putting effort into planning your dates and showing up with a clean car, maybe you need to take a look at, are they putting an effort into this relationship? If you're not a good dater, I mean, how good is the marriage going to be? My mother told me a long time ago, this is as good as it gets. It's not going to get better, which I have to disagree. I have to disagree because our relationship has gotten better. I mean, it was fantastic in the dating, and I think it's even more fantastic now.
Right.
But you planned great dates.
Well, thank you. I appreciate that. So, I think looking around and wherever you live, look around in your city, look to see what's going on this week or this month and what's coming down the pike, because there's a lot of fun things to do everywhere. If there aren't lots of things going on in your town, chances are there's a town pretty close by within an hour's drive that you can find something fun to do, something a little more exciting than just dinner and a movie. When we started dating, it was actually a long time before we even watched a movie together, because
it was a year.
We both kind of had the idea in our head that we wouldn't really get to know each other by just sitting
watching a movie.
Right. It's almost like, okay, just put the date on cruise control, you know, watch the 2-hour movie. And
I agree.
But you know, I have been on plenty of dates where it was dinner and a movie, especially when I was in high school. So
yeah, but I mean, I think you bring up a great point though, Jim, because I actually think that in the first year, I don't think your dates should be dinner and a movie for that very reason. You're not talking, you're not getting to know each other, and it's too easy.
Right.
It's just like a punt almost, not a punt. Almost not a punt, but it doesn't require any imagination or planning to say,
right,
let's go to dinner and movie. Now I enjoy it now. Don't get me wrong. I like a movie theme.
Well,
but you know,
we had endless things to talk about. It's almost like finding your best friend and
long lost best friend,
and it's just, you know, it's just so much to talk about, you know, and so you're just trying to catch up, you know. So that was great. And it was a lot of fun.
It was great.
We did some things that neither one of us had done before. I think we found a music room in our town there was young talent coming in there.
That was fun.
And they were writing songs like right before they got up there, and it was really cool. There was a lot of talent in there, and then there were some other aspiring talent in there, so not everyone was on the same talent level, but everyone was given respect for what they were trying to do up there. And you know, and people would get up there and then say, "Bear with me here. I just
finished this in the parking lot.
I just finished this 30 minutes ago, and so I haven't really even had a chance to practice it. So here we go." And it was fun. I'm not a musician, but it made me feel very creative just watching them do it and enjoying going and getting a beer and just kicking back in the evening and watching them do those things was a lot of fun, because it was takes a lot of courage to get up there and sing or play a musical instrument or both, and they're writing the music, they're performing the music, and it takes a lot of courage to do that.
Yeah, it was really neat. Those were great dates, and that was a great idea too, because all dates don't have to be expensive. I mean, that date was just a couple drinks, because it was free admission to go to this little coffee shop and watch these budding musicians do their thing. That was cool. Yeah, a lot of dates are free.
Right.
I mean, we went hiking on our second date.
Right. We did.
Oh, we went to dinner too. So that was
great. Yeah. It's planning some special things and make special memories, and your date will make note that you're putting in more effort than some of the others. Holly was dating plenty of guys when I met her, and so I had to clear that field.
Yeah, there were a few. But nobody was planning. Well, first of all, I didn't feel about anybody the way I felt about you, but nobody was putting in as much effort into planning the date. So sorry if any of the other guys are watching, but probably they're not. But it just was meant to be. But it was also that I had a fairly high standard for myself of what I was looking for, and I wasn't going to sell myself short. I was happily single. Things were going well for me in my career. And I did want to find somebody. But I did want somebody that was willing to put in, you know, some effort. And quite frankly, all the effort you put into planning the dates, now you put it into planning the things we do married and our trips and our lives and other things. So it's a pretty, you know, high test, really. It's a pretty big test. And I think maybe I should say that I think men should be planning the dates, which is a crazy, old-fashioned, non-feminist thing for me to say, and that is coming from a raving feminist. I am a feminist, and I'm really proud of being a feminist, and have had a successful career, have taken care of myself, have been self-sufficient, and I'm proud of that. And I believe young women have unlimited opportunity and choices and should have those. However, dating isn't about that. Dating isn't about equal opportunity and equal pay. Dating really goes back more of a primeval kind of how men and women work, how hormones and pheromones work. Dating is really not about that.
Can I knock you over the head with the club and call you off on my shoulder?
Isn't that how you got me? You ran faster dragging me than the other guys.
Yeah.
It means that men plan the dates. It means that men pay for the dates. So if you're dating someone and you feel like you need to pay for some of the dates, I wouldn't. I never paid for a date. I still don't pay for dates, even though it comes out of the same bank account now. I do not believe women should be paying for dates. I'm sorry. I'm not sorry. I believe men need to pay for the dates. Here's the problem, and I've talked to a lot of men that couldn't find the right one. The men feel like there's no good women out there, just like the women feel like there's no good men out there. And it's crazy, because I thought there were so many great men out there. I thought it was crazy full of great men out there. It's really kind of how you treat men. They like a refreshing point of view of a woman who appreciates men. But the men I met who didn't feel like they could have found one, they couldn't find the love of their lives, and they were they were getting cynical about dating, the similar to you see with women, a lot of them were not putting an effort into their dates. A lot of them were accepting dates from women who were asking them out, and it was going nowhere. Taking phone calls, I don't call men, never have, never called boys, never called men. We were married for a while, and you text me and you said, are you ever gonna call
me? I said, we're married now, please, you can call me. It's okay.
Right. I still don't really like to call you too much. I don't think people like being pestered on the phone a lot, but when they're trying to work. But I have a very old-fashioned view of dating. I think that a woman can chase a man, and maybe even catch him, and maybe even get him to the altar, and what she really has is a husband that probably will not remember her birthday. Women need to be pursued. We met on Match.com. I did not approach men on Match.com. Men on Match.com approached me, and it worked out quite well. So that's just the nature of it. And you do other nice, gentlemanly, chivalrous things, open car doors and carry things. And if I get a takeout box from the restaurant, you always carry that. It's very nice. It's very nice. So look for a gentleman. You'll be glad you did. That would be my advice to the girls. And act like a lady. Oh, that's something. Yeah. If you want a gentleman, you've got to act like a lady too. So, there's that advice.
I think we did. Awesome. Let us know what you think. How would you plan a date? We'd love to hear some comments from you. Give us some new questions. We're ready to go. So.
It would be cool to get comments on how to plan dates and other things that people do on dates.
So, I'd like to know.
Yeah, that would be neat. That would be really neat.
Yeah, maybe we'll try out some of those ideas. Things.
Please give us a thumbs up and subscribe.
See you next time. Have a zippy vibe day.
What was the original question? And I was fiddling with my hair.